11, yes, one more day of the 12 days of anime. This time we are discussing my top 3 favorite animes from this year and Crunchyroll. You might want to take some notes on actual quality show to win Anime of the Year when the Crunchyroll Anime Awards come out, because yes, Crunchyroll is bringing back the Anime Awards. Hope to God they've learned something from Yuri on Ice. But that is for a later time. So let's begin our list at number 3. Now, number 3 on my list is, of course, Attack on Titan Season 2. I was reviewing that show weekly while that was airing on My Hero Academia Season 2, and what can I say? It was hot. It was lit. 4 years wait. Now, at first, I was like, why 4 years? Why? Because I actually originally assumed that Attack on Titan was, you know, a weekly, you know, manga. Weekly manga. Not, I thought it was just like, you know, some weekly show, but then I found out, like, oh no, Attack on Titan's monthly, which made a lot more sense why Season 2 took so long to come out, because, you know, monthly manga, that, like, kind of, like, cuts the manga chapters in, like, in half, because if you get a chapter every week, it's every month, so the 4 years didn't make sense, along with, you know, Studio Wood was also doing, you know, my Attack on Titan Junior High, you know, and there was also Kabaneri and the Iron Fortress, and also waiting for more chapters to come out, so that they'd have more material to end. So it makes sense why it took so long, but I still would rather we got 24 episodes like Season 1, but you know what, 12 episodes, fine, I'll deal with it, and that means we don't have to wait another 4 fucking years to get another season. I'm happy, I'm good with that. But yeah, Attack on Titan, what can I say about that series? It was just fantastic. I would never say the way it was done was not great. I only had to wait like about a year, because by the time I watched it, which was like last year, because that's like around when I first started getting anime, of course I watched, you know, Attack on Titan, since, you know, everyone, their mothers were talking about that show when I was airing while I was, you know, subbed on Crunchyroll and dubbed on Toonami. Anyway, you know, I didn't have to wait long, only about a year. I'm pretty sure season two was already confirmed by the time I watched it, Attack on Titan. So now the art and animation that show is just great, and I just love how we definitely got a lot more from the cliffhanger in Season 1, you know, the Titans in the Wall, and then now I'm going to keep this as spoiler-free as possible, and then the identity of the armor and the Colossus Titan was not really a surprise, but I was like, I kind of called it a bit, but I was like, oh, that's who they are. So, it was nice to maybe see more of Eren, see more of our man, Levi. Didn't have to do with Yaoi. The show was always just phenomenal. The art animation was great by Studio Wood. The dub was fantastic by Funimation. And the show was just a joy to watch. Especially with it being focused on Ymir and Krista a lot more. And it was nice seeing a little bit more of their characters, you know. And seeing why their borderline Yuri relationship kind of exists. Because in Season 1, Ymir was all over Krista. I mean, it was like, are you two Ladain or something? Like, so we got a lot more of, you know, their relationship. Which was nice to see and kind of make their Yuri-esque relationship make a lot more sense. Anyway, and it was just really just enjoyed the plot twist that happened that series, which is great. And Season 2, I'm hyped, I was so great, but now Season 3, I'm a little concerned about, because a lot of people have been telling me, like, no, it's the political arc, and it's boring. And a lot of people have dropped the manga because of boring. Even a friend of mine said that she dropped Town Titan, like, during this political arc. Anyway. So, as I was saying, so, Attack on Titan, so yeah, where was I? Anyway, oh yeah, Ymir and Krista, so yeah, the relationship, Season 3, I was on Season 3, and yeah, I've heard, like, you know, a friend of mine told me that she, you know, dropped the manga because the political arc was very boring, so I'm kind of scared about Season 3, but hopefully that was probably due to the, you know, the manga was monthly, and you see the same boring stuff month after month without much content. I feel like, you know, when you get that shit, you know, more week to week with them going through maybe probably 2 chapters a day per episode, it'll probably be a lot more easier to judge it and a lot more enjoyable to watch. Hopefully. So that's why Attack on Titan Season 2 is number 3 on my list. Now, number 2 goes to Inuyashiki. Now, this was definitely like the surprise hit of 2017. Now, my first girlfriend as well was definitely one of the most surprised hits of 2017, because at first I was like, okay, this is gonna be an interesting faster than me. Then I turned to like, oh shit, this show is actually really good. But then when I saw Inuyashiki, when I saw Inuyashiki, I was like, god damn, this show good. This is definitely one damn good anime, and a contestant for Anime of the Year. I mean, this show is so good. And that first episode, oh, my heart. I mean, at one moment I'm pissed off, the next moment I'm sad, then I'm back to being pissed off, then I'm sad, then I'm happy at the end. Like, that first episode was just so good. The voice acting from the sub was so good. I mean, wow. That first episode alone was so good. Inuyashiki, you know, the old man, like, you know, that first episode, the man, what that man went through in that first episode was just, I mean, it was crazy. It was insane. Then the show just got better and better and better and better. And I'm like, yes, this is definitely an anime of the year contestant. And it's better get nominated by Crunchyroll. You better nominate this, Crunchyroll. You better not screw it. You better not screw it. Because that show was just so good. Like, the characters were all fantastic. Like, the best way I can describe it for someone that isn't seen, it's a lot like Chronicle. You know, the found footage superhero movie? It's a lot like that mindset. If you took out the found footage aspect of it and replaced it with, you know, and superpowers and replaced it with, like, you know, cyborgs, and, you know, it was filmed like normally. I mean, the references, there are so many references. I mean, they're referencing One Piece, Attack on Titan. Hell, there's even a reference on fucking Astro Boy. When I saw that Astro Boy, I was laughing. I was like, no reference again from like the 60s. But yeah, Inuyashiki is surprising. Now, granted, if you want to watch it, which I highly recommend you do, it unfortunately is only available on Anime Strike legally, so yeah, do what you gotta do. I love the series, and if you're a big fan of, you know, seinen series, if you're a fan of Chronicle, I highly recommend you check out Inuyashiki. That's why it's number two on my list. Now, talk about some honorable mentions. Of course, you know, My First Girlfriend is a Gal is a big one. Fae Apocrypha was another great one. Food War Season 3 was great. Probably put two posters up here because otherwise, if I keep talking, I'll probably put this whole screen up with all my posters. My First Girlfriend is a Gal. Food Wars was another great one from this season. Fae Apocrypha was another great one. What else? Kakegurui. Kakegurui was another fantastic anime that I really hope does get a season 2. I love My First Girlfriend is a Gal. Yeah, that's about it. There's probably a few other animes I'm missing that are not. Oh, Interview with Monster Girls and Saga of the Titan of the Evil. Those were all some fantastic animes that came out this year. So yeah, those are my honorable mentions. Now, number one. You guys already knew what it was. You already knew. It is, of course, My Hero Academia Season 2. What do I have to say about the series other than it's fantastic? Now, is it as good as Naruto? No. But it has the potential of dethroning Naruto as the GOAT of Shonen Jump from what I've watched, which I haven't even started shipping it yet. So, yeah. But from what I saw, My Hero Academia was fantastic. I mean, the tournament arc, you know, the sports festival is just great. I mean, Uraraka. I felt bad for her when she was going up against Bakugo and Deku versus Todoroki. I mean, Studio Bones, you have outdone yourselves. That was just great. And the Stain arc. Oh, the Stain arc. Oh, that arc was just fantastic. And I see a lot more of the character from there towards Ida was great. And then when we got Deku and Bakugo going up against All Might, that was just absolute greatness there. That was just absolute greatness, I mean. That was just absolute greatness. Anime greatness. And the soundtrack was great, and Studio Bones. They are the GOATs. I call them the GOATs for the reason. I mean, you just gotta watch a few episodes of Hero Welcome to know. Yeah, they are the GOATs. Because these guys animate like nobody's business. It's just, the characters great, and the dub. Funimation, you outdid yourself with that dub. I was with that same, especially because this was same day sound. You know, like we got on the same day in Japan dub, which was nice. Granted, it stopped around like the stain, right at the start of the stain, which was kind of disappointing. They made it wait 2 weeks for the dub episodes to come back, which I was disappointed with. I was like, come on, Funimation, at least give me like a heads up. Tell me, like, you know, oh yeah, we're gonna, oh yeah, it's gonna be like the last episode we're doing same day simul dubs for. Like, I would like to get a little bit of morning from your Funimation, but I'm not going to sleep over it. But, I mean, there's not much more to say about My Hero Academia Season 2. It was just fantastic. Even the filler episode we got of Focus on Sue was also fantastic to watch. It was nice to see a little bit more of her on screen. And, you know, it was great. And I'm so hyped to see Season 3, seeing more of All for One, seeing Deku, you know, go up against Shigaraki, the new members of the League of Villains. Yeah, it's just going to be great. It's going to be hype. I'm so hyped for spring 2017. And now that I'm on My Hero Academia Season 2, is number one on my list. So that is my top three favorite animes of 2017. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Leave a like if you did. Subscribe if you're new. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Links in the description box below. And as always, come back for more. See you guys next time.